The communication route is the second route in the sequence and doesn't only address the quality of your communication, but emphasizes the importance of taking time to communicate your qualities. Communication is defined as an exchange of thought, feeling, or information. This is a targeted conversation that must be set up and positioned correctly. You can't ask someone a profound question about your career, future, or potential while standing in line at the grocery store or during a short elevator ride. It doesn't matter how your question sounds if it's presented out of bounds. You need a specific date, time, and agenda so you're both in the proper state of mind and prepared to have an exploratory conversation about making important decisions. You're trying to move the needle from being busy to being effective, from satisfied to gratified, and from maintenance mode to growth mode. You've got to make time for this conversation in the right environment for this potentially defining moment. Identify a good coach, mentor, trusted advisor. A coach is for hire, a mentor is someone you admire, and a trusted advisor is someone who has your best interests at heart, someone who will likely be a rich resource of ideas and information, and someone who's in your corner and will follow up with you to ensure that good ideas are implemented. When you ask for their time, say something like, "Hey Bob, I need your input on a few things I'm working on. When will you have about an hour in the next week or so to help me think through some business opportunities?" This helps them understand the purpose of your call, the nature of the subject matter, and the time required to be productive. Remind them that their role is to not only explore a few ideas, but to clarify, analyze, and identify your next steps. It's not only about discussing your talents, but determining what you should do with them. To do this, you should engage in a dialogue filled with open-ended questions and, in the communication world, what's referred to as drill downs. Open-ended questions obligate the listener to answer questions with unbiased answers. They encourage deeper dialogue with drill downs like, "How do you mean? In what way? Describe that for me. In what context? What sorts of activities? What makes it difficult for you? How are you handling that now?" This is the time to be interested, not interesting. Instead of asking closed-ended questions that elicit simple, brief answers like, "Do you get along well with your boss?" you ask, "Tell me about your relationship with your boss." Instead of, "Isn't that difficult to do?" you ask, "How would I go about getting that done?" Instead of, "Is that a reasonable goal for me?" you could ask, "What do you think about me pursuing that goal?" And depending on how they answer, you can drill further with follow-up questions such as why or how. When your coach says, "I don't think you would enjoy the process," your next question isn't a quick assumption like, "Is it the long hours or the people I work with?" If you want an unbiased answer without leading them, simply ask, "Why is that?" The intention of your ongoing communication is to draw out as much valuable information and brainstorming as possible. At the end of your discussion, be sure to ask, "What do you think are my next steps?" Or, "If you were in my shoes, what would you do next?" Schedule a follow-up appointment at the end of each meeting to measure results and share your experiences. The clarity and frequency of your communication will sustain your motivation. Follow-up dates place urgency on your activities and hold you accountable for implementation. Without this constructive pressure, you'll procrastinate and your meeting will merely amount to informal therapy without making actual progress. Subsequent discussions should revolve around your basic values. If your identified talents lead to assignments and careers that conflict with other priorities or clash with your lifestyle choices, you'll lose interest in your quest. I knew someone in Los Angeles who thought they wanted to be a financial advisor but didn't want to be in the office every day at 5 a.m. Your values should be carefully considered when pursuing goals. Otherwise, you'll find yourself swimming against the tide. If you choose goals that are aligned with your values, you can ride the wave to shore. And the values route is the subject of our next chapter.